I'm going to speak a little bit of genealogy, and in continuance of that particular line group, it's a very fun one. It keeps going. If you go through the Capet, you find Emperor Claudius, and you find Maximilian, and also Marcus. Others then of interest are Constantine the First. Now, Constantine the First was the man who, interesting because of its relation to me, somehow for sure, I guess it would have to be a blood test for sure, but interesting, my choice of Byzantine as the French surrounds as a placing for the kingdom. Very interesting because Constantine the First was the founder of the Byzantine zone. So he already had stated this and had founded it, and so it was not anything new. It was going on quite before with Claudius also. However, it actually was given the namesake at that time, Byzantine. So that's a little strangeness because I found this information out, and then yet before, it's just on a whim. You know, I could have said Ottoman, I could have said Ottoman Empire, but no, I said Byzantine, and yet now I find that when I'm going through this genealogy line, that this Celtic Casimir site, that I am in essence there. From the Constantine First, and who is the founder of, and yet again, there it is again, religion. He is bringing Catholicism, but not Catholicism at the time, knowing as that it is just a straight up bringing the Christianity. So I think that could be overmixed, maybe Catholicism and Christianity. I think they've overmixed those two as being synonymous through history. Pretty much sure it was just a stopping of paganisms, of all of the different types of you know, it was a tribe, it was a main way of keeping a tribe together, and they used Christianity as a tribal a gathering for their armies of people. You know, you're with it or you're not with it. You know, that's just the way it goes. And if when you're with it, then already you're part of that community, and that helps the Byzantine in its growth power. So he didn't live very long, actually. Only lived the 2 years. He died from I believe the smallpox, they say. But and he was going to give his succession to another, and yet another brother took it. I'm not sure who the other was. I haven't had time to verify it, but a brother took it that he did not want it, to have it. So it's interesting, you know. So out of his short time there as emperor, it was not a very long emperorness, and yet he had a brother just snatch it up off of its platter. So that's interesting. Because I do have quite an aggressive family. I have quite an aggressive group against me. I feel they actually prefer my death. I have said that already on these videos, that they really are aggravations to anything conductive of truth. When it goes back into history, it is almost as if they just want to live their little life that they were born in 1960 or 1950 or whatever, and that's it, and then play dead, and that nothing is a valiant of before, nothing is of worth, and nothing is of value. So I'm kind of like wondering the predicament of them. I find them to be completely homed in to somebody else, homed into somebody else, living under another ruler, being as such swayed. And incapacitated, absolutely incapacitated as a leader, completely unskilled, because their only reason is to usurp me, and be what? just the other schmo on the street who has no power. Be it the other schmo on the street who has no power. So we're just a world of schmoes on the street. That's there, that's who they are. So, here I am now. Here I am now. I am Constantine the First, the great emperor. And I'm also, well, they call him Constantine the Great, and Claudius. Claudius the Second and Claudius the First. And I believe there's a Marcus in there that is kind of important. But interesting, I learned that Caesar itself, the name Caesar, it means ruler. It does not actually mean Julius Caesar. And so often in history we're like, Julius Caesar, you know, that is the ruler. Julius Caesar only a name, but no, they often call the emperor Caesars. So that was something I've learned out of the history. So fun for everybody. I've ordered the chicken and duck food, and so they will have chicken and duck food. It should be arriving next couple of days. What else? Yeah, that's a big windfall, huh? To all of a sudden find myself there as Maximilian style emperors of dynasties great, and yes, they were not incapable of just saying, well, there's wars gauged and there are 30,000 dead, and that was the way it went. So for me, that is not a difficult understanding as a person, which I find incredible, because I know others who would weep at the thought. So whether that is something from a personality that runs through into the brain, even that far back, and we're talking back to 300, talking back to 200, we're talking back to 200 AD, back to, I don't know, this is like 50, 60 year generations or so. So yeah, long time, but however, Quite an interesting discovery that I chose Byzantine on a whim, almost as if it is already ruling through me, that particular direction, as an obvious. That was just easy, you know, an instinct born, and I did not need the internet, I did not need genealogy to tell me this, and yet I am given the second answer, that yes, that is correct, Byzantine, and that is a part of your beginnings. So, yeah. Anyway, that's all for today.